Moving on, Shankaran sends us a question through email. Now, he purchased an under-construction property costing 45 lakh rupees plus other charges, which amount to around 8 lakh rupees. These include township corpus fund, development charges, maintenance charge, legal charges, club membership, generator charges, etc. Now, he wants to know, does he have to pay TDS of 1% or not? The builder is deducting service tax.
Now, first of all, I think there are two questions. And let me clarify. The TDS is one thing, service tax is another thing. They are not interconnected. TDS at the rate of 1% is payable on the value of the consideration for which you are buying the property. So, as you have stated in your question, 45 lakhs is the value of the property that you are purchasing. And that being less than 50 lakhs, there is no obligation for you to deduct TDS of 1% from the builder. So, on the consideration, which is aggregating to 45 lakhs, which you're going to pay to the builder, you don't have to have any withholding tax or there is no TDS of 1%, and you can pay the entire consideration to him. That is because the total consideration is less than 50 lakhs. The 8 lakhs that you are paying is for other services or for excess, ancillary things, which on which the title is not coming to you. So, for example, when you are paying for the clubhouse, you are not becoming the owner of the clubhouse. Or if you are paying for other services, you are not becoming the owner of that. Therefore, that is not a sale consideration that you are paying. And therefore, it is only the sharing of the cost that you are paying. So, therefore, that 8 lakhs should not be added into that 45 lakhs. So, and if you add that, then only it exceeds 50 lakhs.
Pankaj, do you think that Shankaran also needs to take a look at the agreement? Because a lot of developers add all of these charges into the overall cost of the house. And if this 8 lakhs that he speaks about, if that is added into the overall cost of the house, in that case, will he have to pay TDS?
No, because, see, again, even in the agreement, even if it is included, he would have mentioned that, okay, for the clubhouse, you will pay so much, for the generator, you will pay so much, for this, you will pay so much. So, if those are specifically mentioned, then the value of the property that you are buying is 45 lakhs, which will clearly come out from the agreement. And in that case, you don't have to worry about no TDS.
So, if what you're essentially saying is, if the developer is giving you this breakup in the agreement, you need not pay the TDS.
Yes.
But if there is no breakup that is given in the agreement, the way you have broken it up and given it to us, if that breakup does not exist, then he has to pay the TDS.
Yes. Right? And, if the builder is not objecting, on the safe side, deduct the TDS, pay it and forget about it, pay it to the government and forget about it, because there you are not going wrong. If TDS is payable and not paid by you, then there could be a problem. If the TDS is not at all payable, and if you deduct in addition to that, there is no harm.
Right.
So, if the builder does not object, please go ahead and deduct 1% and pay it.
Okay. So, the builder is the best guide in this matter, you're saying?
Yeah.
But again, if you still have your doubts, what Pankaj just clarified essentially is, if the breakup is given, then you need not pay the TDS. If there is no breakup, if the total value of the house comes to 52 lakh rupees as per your agreement, then yes, you will have to pay the TDS. However, if you're still in doubt, it doesn't harm. There is no harm. Go consult a tax lawyer and they will tell you exactly what you need to do.
You can watch live TV on our website, mbnow.in. Find us on Facebook at facebook.com/magicbricksnow. And don't forget to click the like button. You can also follow us on Twitter at magicbricksnow. To stay updated with all our programming, hit the subscribe button on our YouTube channel by logging on to youtube.com/magicbricksnow.